If you ask me about this Young Thug Rico trial, it's been a shambles from the beginning. This is a soup sandwich from the beginning. This should have been thrown out a long, long time ago, especially after Woody took the stand and did what he did on the stand, basically made fun of the damn prosecution the entire time, had them wrapped around his finger. Woody said what he had to say, made it his way, and gave them nothing. All he did was expose how incompetent the prosecution was in this case. Well, guess what? A lot of people have been saying that online too. It's not just us. Have been saying that the Young Thug trial is a bust. Let Thugger go, free them men's, and put this case to rest, because this is just total and utter garbage. But guess who's also starting to think the same way? The judge. Welcome back to BrainFlow.tv/HottopixxTV. If you've never been here before, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Click the bell next to the subscribe button so you are notified every time a new video goes up on this channel. Young Thug's trial judge went at the prosecutors, questions whether they hide the ball. What are y'all doing? Really? The judge is basically saying to them, I've been wanting to not say this for the longest, because I didn't want to like disrespect you or you know, put you down or anything, but I can't help but say it now, because it's gone too far for too long. What are you doing? When a judge says that to a prosecution, you know, the judge is basically saying at this point, you know, I might have to really start thinking about a mistrial and letting these guys go, because every day I come in here and I sit down to a shit show. Now, according to paperwork, it says Young Thug's long and troubled racketeering trial appears on the verge of a dramatic mistrial, and that happened on Monday. Today, as the Atlanta-based judge accused chief prosecutor of either purposefully misleading the court or causing chaos through apparent disorganization. It doesn't get no simpler than that. If you're wondering what the judge is talking about, I just said it. The judge accused the chief prosecutor of either purposely misleading the courts or causing chaos through apparent disorganization. The judge said, I can't take this no more. Here are the judge's words, quote unquote. The judge said, it is baffling to me that somebody with the number of years of experience that you have, time after time after time, continues to seemingly purposefully hide the ball to the extent you possibly can for a as long as you possibly can. This is Fulton County Judge Paige Reese speaking to the lead prosecutor in this RICO trial against Young Thug. Judge Paige Reese Whitaker told Chief Deputy District Attorney Adrienne Love after one of Young Thug's lawyers demanded that a mistrial happens based on the way that a witness was handled. Quote unquote, I really don't want to believe that it is purposeful. But honestly, after a certain number of times, you start to wonder how it could be anything but that. Unless it's just that you are so unorganized that you are throwing this case together as you try it. Damn, that's embarrassing. If the judge says your case looks like you're just throwing this shit together as you try it, either that or you're purposely misleading the courts, what does that tell you? What does that tell you? It tells you that Young Thug could pretty much be out of there sometime soon. Okay, and it tells you that the prosecutor cannot handle this case, not like they thought it was going to be. They thought this was going to be a slam dunk. The problem is, Young Thug's money is long, and Young Thug's attorneys are top-tier attorneys. So now, we have the prosecutor who poorly put this case together, have now been fumbling left, right, and center, trying to fit the pieces back together, and the judges seeing them play Etch-a-Sketch and fitting the pieces together right in front of her. And she's like, this is not how you try a case. This is not how it should be. You should come to court with all your years of experience properly, well put together, and ready to go. But it seems like you're just connecting the dots right in front of me as we go along kind of thing. Whitaker got so heated, which is the attorney, which is the judge, Reese Whitaker. She got so heated that she called a recess to cool down and to consider a mistrial motion in private. You know what? I think I smell a mistrial coming. When she returned, she said that the trial would continue, but that she wasn't letting anything slide. She came back and she said, quote unquote, I think my frustration was apparent a few minutes ago. I think she went to her chambers. She probably took a shot of scotch or something. Woosahed herself back there. Whew, took a couple of breaths. I can't believe this is happening in my courtroom. I could see why everybody else ran away from this case. I think my frustrations was apparent a few minutes ago. I truly am struggling with whether all of this is purposeful or this is just really poor lawyering on the part of members of the state's team. Either way, it's really unfortunate. If it's something other than poor lawyering, then it's more than unfortunate. At this point, we're going to just move on with testimony. I don't know if I can stress any more than I already have how much the state's lawyers need to make an effort to be upfront and forthright in this trial case. This is embarrassing. This case is about to get thrown out. Young Thug, born Jeffrey Williams, if y'all don't know, he has pled not guilty to 8 counts that he has been charged with in a gang and racketeering conspiracy indictment, first announced in 2022. Prosecutors alleged that Young Thug, or Williams, was the head of a violent criminal street gang named Young Slime Life. Williams currently is on trial with 5 other co-defendants in the case after more than 20 others were charged in the indictment, either took plea deals or had their cases severed. Williams, who is Young Thug, his trial started with jury selection in January of 2023. We are in October of 2024. And it had opening statements last November. Now, the longest running trial in Georgia history. Even the state's making money off of this. Because somebody has to pay those attorneys to work on behalf of the state. To represent the state. It already has survived a prior judge getting recused, taken off the case, from the case against his will. Multiple allegations of prosecutorial misconduct lodged by defense lawyers and highly contentious testimony from a key witness whose I don't recall reply became a famous meme. And we're talking about Woody. Now, when Judge Whitaker assumed the lead position off the trial in July, she said that her plan was to move forward efficiently and expeditiously after prior setbacks. On Monday, the judge said that when Williams' defense objected to a document as hearsay, the court overruled the objection and allowed Love, the prosecutors, to show the document to a witness because Love promised that it wouldn't be used to authenticate anything. The judge blasted Love, the lead prosecutor, for subsequently showing the document and asking the witness, Deputy District Attorney Michael Sprinkel, to connect a phone number on the document to another defendant in the case. Judge Whitaker said that that appeared to be a violation of what Love, the chief prosecutor, promised the court. Went completely opposite of what you promised the court that you would do. For her part, Love said that she didn't need the document to prove who owned the phone number. She told the courts that she was shown the document to help explain how Sprinkel ended up following certain leads. More than 70 witnesses have testified so far in this high-profile trial. Prosecutors have said that they intend to call more than 100 witnesses that are left on their list. After that, lawyers for each of the six defendants will have a chance to call their own set of witnesses. The trial is expected to last throughout the end of the year, possibly way into February, March, April, May of next year, 2025, Judge Whitaker has said. This is bullshit. That, and pardon my language, but I want y'all to think about this on the outside. If nobody tries this case, then no money is made. Somebody got to try the case to make money. In other words, lawyers don't get no money unless they have a case to try. So somebody has figured out a way to make money off the system for going on 2 years. Or even over 2 years, because this came down in 2022 and we're in 2024. And like I said before, somebody has to pay these attorneys to prosecute on behalf of the state. And that's a lot of money being paid hourly. So the fact that the judge now feels like they are purposely like just stringing this along as they go, or they're purposely maligning this case, it is probably to extend the case. It is probably to keep it going and going and going. And they still have 100 witnesses left to call. And then the defense is going to call, all six attorneys on the defense side is going to call their own set of witnesses. Oh my God. Listen, just throw this whole case away. This is garbage. Leave your comments in the comment section below. Tell me what you think about this one. And I'll catch you on the next video. It's HottopixxTV/BrainFlowTV. You already know if the topic is hot, we're on it. I'm out. Peace.